Hello, my name's Glenn Nice. I'm the Pesticide Applicator Training Program Manager here at the state, here at UAW, and welcome to the CCA training. In the next five sections, we're going to cover five topics: applicator certification and licensing, pesticide use records, environmental protection, surface water and groundwater protection, and employee and public protection. On to the first section. Applicator certification and licensing. The PAT program here at the UAW provides training materials and, might I add, reference materials for both private and commercial categories. You have probably been through this process before, and if not, you'll be having to go through this process before you can apply pesticides in Wisconsin. The private manual is a different manual than the commercial field and vegetable manual, and both of them are geared towards those specific categories. Let's talk about some of the prominent laws that deal with pesticides within the United States. The first one to consider is the national law, which is FIFRA, or Federal Insecticide, Fungicide, Rodenticide Act. FIFRA sets the framework for the pesticide laws within the United States. However, each state has the freedom to make laws within the state regarding pesticides. Now, the rule is they can make the laws only more restrictive. They cannot make them easier. For example, if there is a federal law that says you must be certified if using restricted use pesticides, a state cannot make that easier by saying, no, you don't have to be. It can only make it more restrictive. The federal laws are regulated by the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency. You've probably come across them before and heard about them before. ATCAP 29 is the state law within Wisconsin. It deals predominantly with pesticides within Wisconsin and certification and licensing. It is regulated or administered by the Department of Agriculture, Trade, and Consumer Protection, lovingly known as DATCAP. Let's kind of talk about two major groups of applicators. There are private applicators and there are commercial applicators. As a CCA, you may come across both these categories. What's the difference? Well, a private applicator must do both of two things. They must produce an agricultural commodity, and they must do applications made on their property. What does that mean? Well, they have to produce a crop. This could be corn, soybean, alfalfa, or a number of different things. It can also be forestry products. But it has to be an agricultural commodity. And they have to do this on land that they own or rent or manage. And then everybody else, if you do not fit both of these criteria, everybody else is a commercial applicator. So there are some exceptions to that private applicator rule. For example, a private applicator can apply on someone else's property for goods and services. What's goods and services? Well, for example, I do the applying on your property, you own the combine, you harvest my soybeans. That is a goods and service. However, if money exchanges hands, then there's new exceptions that have to be kept up on. For example, if money changes hands, a private applicator can apply on up to 500 acres of someone else's property for three or less producers a year. So let's sort of break that out. If I'm going to apply 506 acres, I am now a commercial applicator and I must be certified as a commercial applicator. If I'm going to apply 400 acres for four people, I am again a commercial applicator and must get commercially certified and licensed. Let's sort of, this can be a little confusing, but let's sort of break this out into examples. So a private applicator typically is a farmer or a farm worker. The farm worker, of course, being employed by the farmer and applying pesticides only on that farmer's property. Commercial is everybody else. For example, True Green, the gentleman that applies the pesticides on your lawn, is a commercial applicator. A school custodian is considered a commercial applicator. A field rep, so a CCA, if you are giving recommendations for pesticides, you are considered a commercial applicator. A co-op applicator, of course, being applying for cash, is also a commercial applicator. What's kind of confusing is, in the eyes of the law, a homeowner applying pesticides to their own property is also considered a commercial applicator. Now, do they have to be certified and licensed? No, but we'll get to that in a second. Certification is a must when these triggers are actually pulled. For example, if you apply a restricted use pesticide, no matter what happens, you must be certified and licensed. Whether you're a homeowner, whether you're doing it on your own property, whether you're private or whatever. If you are applying a restricted use pesticide, you must be certified. That trumps everything else. Applying any pesticide for hire, you must be certified within the state of Wisconsin. Applying to public school property, K through 12, custodians that apply pesticides also have to be certified. Applying in the waters of the state, this is kind of an odd one, because to get a permit to do this, you are required by the DNR to be certified. So you kind of have to be certified anyways. If the label requires it, some products, not many, but a few products dictate that you have to be trained or certified to be able to use it. An example of this is habitat or soil fumigants. Now, direct the application. If you are directing volunteers or directing other people to do applications, you also have to be certified. Well, we found out who has to be certified, but not everybody has to be certified even though they're considered a commercial applicator. We break different certifications or different applications down into four different groups. There are commercial applicators for hire, commercial applicators not for hire, mixer and loaders, and registered trainees. What is the difference? What does this mean? Well, for hire, as we mentioned, are people who collect money or in a contract state apply pesticides. Not for hire are people like homeowners who apply pesticides or on their own property, or volunteers. DNR often has a lot of people volunteering to apply pesticides to control invasive species on their property. A mixer loader is an odd category where that individual only mixes and loads tanks. They do not apply. If you are certified as a mixer and loader, you cannot apply. And if DATCAP finds you applying, you're probably going to get some kind of a fine. Registered trainee is an odd category or an odd group of applicators. You are allowed to get a registered trainee category if you are training to be an applicator. What this allows you to do is apply for 30 days. You are not allowed to apply restricted use pesticides, but you can apply other pesticides for 30 days for money. And after 30 days, you must get certified. You can only get this registered trainee category once. So after you've had it for 30 days, you got to get certified. All right, that's the first section over with. The next section is pesticide use records.